books and lovers. The Musing Sense series is much more than just a description of these diagrams. It is also about connecting these diagrams to other ideas and thinkers and showing how these diagrams can clarify their thoughts. If you're new to this channel, you are probably wondering what on earth I'm talking about. If that's the case, you will find in the description the links to my videos where I introduce this diagram that I'll be using in this video. In this video, we connect the diagram to Jordan Hall's ideas on the explore mode and habit mode. There is no commentary over Jordan's speaking, as these ideas are very similar to the ideas already expressed earlier in the Musing Sense series. I have only highlighted different parts of the diagram according to what aspect Jordan is currently talking about. The point of this video is to show how the diagram can be used as a dynamic tool for thinking. The diagram clarifies the different components of Jordan's ideas and helps us to see how they relate to one another. But without further ado, here's the short video.
Inside the concept of thinking, there is at least one major distinction. I'm certain there are more, but there's at least one, which is between an approach to the environment that is tuned to and adaptive to novelty. We might think about this as, in the poster call it explore mode. Right? So here we are listening closely, observing closely, very little preconceived notions about what it is that we're perceiving, and in many ways slowly and carefully and somewhat lightly grasping things that are in fact not well understood and endeavoring to come to grips with them on their own terms. Right? So this is explore mode. And then standing in contrast to explore mode is what I called habit mode. So in habit mode, we have some framework for making sense of and responding to our environment. The example I used was after you have learned how to drive a car, the habit of driving a car. So very quickly, you can take your previously generated frame that has very crisp patterns that it can recognize and very specific responses that it can activate. And so in habit mode, our job is to do a good job at quickly recognizing predefined patterns and then effectively executing scripts for predefined and practiced responses. And so these two modes are adaptive to different conditions. When we find ourselves in a circumstance of high novelty, then explore mode is the right approach. And we find ourselves in circumstances of low novelty, then habit mode is a generally good approach. So both explore mode and habit mode are properly part of thinking. Thinking involves the skillful and fluid application of these different tools in different environments. In some environments, in some environments, explore mode is right, in other environments, habit mode is right. And oftentimes one might actually need to go back and forth in the same environment. And so the notion is that there's in normal thinking, there's a fluid relationship between habit mode and explore mode, where those aspects of life that are most, that can be pattern recognized as being more or less identical to circumstances that we've dealt with in the past and therefore can be addressed effectively using well-worn habits, are the appropriate domain of habit mode. I've actually learned that apparently Brits notice that Americans, because we've been driving more and longer, drive in habit mode in a way that's actually a little bit frightening.
Right.
Talk and think while driving in a way that isn't ordinary for them.
Right.
And then, of course, we have explore mode, right, where we're quite specifically not allowing what's happening to be run into habits of thinking and habits of acting, but rather are moving more slowly through experience and paying attention in a more open-ended way, seeking potential patterns that may or may not be arising for which to respond. So this is ordinary thinking.